What's up, guys? Today, it's not fast enough. Oh yeah. Man, I don't know. I've been flying brushless whoop, 1S, 2S. It's fucking dope. It's really nice. I really like it. But when I plug a battery on my not fast enough Slverware, it's just magic. You feel so connected to your tiny whoop, and I'm loving it. I can fly it anywhere. So today I went for a forest ride, and yeah, you're gonna probably see my video soon. I know I post video every single day, guys. I'm sorry, I apologize for it. Right now, I'm in the mood of flying brush whoop. And I'm trying to fly as low as I can and pop some tricks randomly if I can. Sorry. While I fly in the forest, it's kinda hard to see what's going on. So sometimes I'm just cruise, and when I'm confident, trust, whatever, I push the throttle and just go and then do some tricks. And this is how I improve my skills, if we can call it like that. But yeah, I'm always trying to find some new spot. It's like I was flying a 5-inch or something, but it's just a poor DVR. But the flying experience, it's fucking amazing. Yeah, not fast enough brush quad, it's nice, it's dope, guys. So by the way, thank you for people who try my TKS, aka Tarkusx frame, for trying. I really like it. It's different from flying a tiny whoop. It's more powerful because it's open props, and yeah. And another thing, I've been designing some stuff randomly for myself, but I always try to share them. And as a 3D designer, I'm really casual. I'm still learning, but at least I try and I'm learning something. And if I fail at it, I just restart and look at it. One more thing about the Betafpv Slverware brushes. Right now it's only 2S and it's not ready. Really not ready. I tried it and I tried to tune it, even if the problems was about the filters. It still doesn't improve the flight, and it doesn't match with the classic Slverware. So yeah, as a PGC, Patrick G. Clark from Project Mockingbird, say that Slverware was mainly for a brush quad, and it gave you way more power than the beta flight. And it's true, but for brushless, I'm not sure it will improve something. Slverware, it's like a religion. It just fly really fucking nice. But if you want to adjust your stuff, your rates, your PIDs and all, you have to mess with the code. And yeah, but with the Betaflight, Betafpv, you can adjust your PIDs, motor direction, your receiver directly from the OSD, and you can hook any ERICs on it. I mean, FR Sky, Crossfire, yeah, Crossfire, the SMX Spectrum, and Bayang. And I don't know if Fly Sky work? I don't remember. But yeah. But the problem right now with the Betafpv Slverware, it's those tiny pads around the OSD chips. When you want to solder your little wire to flash it, it's a goddamn mess. Already burned one FC. And on my second FC, it was fine. But still, it's really annoying to play with this flight controller right now. And I told Betafpv to change it. So yeah. So don't forget to apply for the beta test things that Betafpv posted. Good luck, guys, and more cool stuff coming up.